Hello, my name is Julia Rowe, and I'm a physician assistant with Advanced Dermatology. So one of the most frequent complaints I've gotten from patients since moving to New York from Atlanta is dry skin. For now, with all the heaters running in the winter air, but really dry skin is a complaint people will have year round. So what are some things that we can do from home to combat dry skin? One of the things that's most helpful is to understand what's happening in your skin when it feels dry. So the very outermost layer of our skin is called the stratum corneum, and it's made out of a layer of cells that stick together like this so that bad things can't get in and good things stay inside and are protected in our skin, namely moisture. So what happens when your skin dries out is the skin cells don't have the support that they need and gaps start to form. These gaps then have water leak out the way you would expect, and that's called transepidermal water loss. One of the temptations for us when we see our skin cells split like this is that it looks like it's flaking, and the temptation then is to scrub the flakes off. But actually what we want to do is provide the backbone that the skin needs to stick back together and provide a nice barrier for the moisture to stay inside. So what are some ways that we can do that? First is to actually have good shower hygiene or good shower habits. We don't want to take too many frequent showers and too many long hot showers. Ideally, it's just once a day, maybe even once every other day in lukewarm water. Second would be in the soaps that you decide to use. Heavily fragranced and antibacterial soaps tend to be very, very drying. In the summer months, your skin might be able to handle it, but in drier weather, using gentler soaps that are not as drying is the way to go. The next would be to use good moisturizer, especially as soon as you get out of the shower. While the steamy bathroom is still in your way, you want to towel dry real quick and throw on a nice moisturizer so we can seal in all of that great water into your skin. So what are some good moisturizers out on the market now? Cetaphil cream is a great go-to. Aveeno and Aquaphor is also a great go-to, as well as Eucerin, I believe it's called Advanced Repair Cream. A note for those of us who are helping little ones with their dry skin, sometimes Eucerin can be stinging, and you may find that they complain about that and won't let you put moisturizer on. So for those of us with littles, maybe stick to just Cetaphil or Aquaphor when you're trying to moisturize your skin. Lastly, but also important, would be to consider having humidifiers in your home. If the air is dry, the moisturizer that should be inside is now leaking out into the air instead of staying into your skin. So use cool mist humidifiers to safely get some moisture into the air. If you've done all of these things to the best of your ability and you're still struggling with dry skin or it's itching and painful, there may be other medical things going on beyond just dryness, and I'd be happy to help you with that. Come on in and see me, Julia Rowe, at Advanced Dermatology. Thanks so much for joining.